Versify here, and welcome back to Spyro. Sorry it's been so long. Yeah, I really am okay, don't worry. I didn't, in the middle of, between the videos, I chose to kill myself. It felt so good. Wait, there's another Sheila stage? Oh, fucking hell, we gotta, that's stupid, we didn't do this one. We gotta do this one now. Alright, let's fucking go in here. Wait, what? Okay, let's go. Shit, I fucking missed that. Yeah, they put more Sheila levels in Agent 9. I guess because they thought kids would like the isometric viewpoint. Space. Let's jump start those heaters. Oh, that was terrible. I'm gonna kill myself. So, yes, I'm okay, like I said. Don't worry. What else? Oh, I did not work today because I wasn't feeling good. I was having really bad stomach aches. Probably from just eating junk food all this damn time. So, yeah. I'm suing McDonald's. Just kidding. Oh, what else? Oh, I got the audio working. That's the most important and relevant part. Yes, I finally, after trial and error, I got the audio much louder than it would record at its maximum settings. So, yeah, I can actually turn stuff down for once instead of leaving, you know, my mic. You know, my mic would be, like, very overpowered, and that'd be, like, 1% volume, and then the game volume would be 100 and still be a little too quiet, so, yeah. Especially that one video, oh my god, it's recorded shit so quietly. But, yes, I don't have to adjust settings anymore, and I am now completely ready. Watch this, I'm gonna say that, I'm gonna get to the video editing, the whole fucking video's gonna be corrupted, and then I'm gonna kill myself. Alright. Sounds like a plan, let's go. Kill this fucker. Oh my god, just stop, please. Oh my god, just die, please. Okay. Alright. So, as you saw, the goal of this is to heat up the heaters so the mountain doesn't turn to ice, even though it has fucking sparks, it's blind. I like the animations. The heaters are just like going their hard. They're trying their hardest. They're sweating. There's lots of hot air coming from them. They're fucking hot. Also, if that's the case, how the fuck does Sheila stand on this without burning her fucking feet? The world may never know. Well, I guess she could technically be immune to it because she lives in the, you know, in the in Australia, theme plan, whatever, or Austria to piss those Australians off. I guess by that sense, she could be immune to standing on something that hot, because, you know, she always stands on stuff that's hot. You know, the ground, I don't fucking know. I'm looking way too deep into this. Oh yeah, we have to go around, so. And the boulders fucking explode. Oh god. Alright. Alright, fuck these guys. Alright. Imagine if the boulder he threw hit the heater and caused a giant fucking explosion. And everyone fucking died. I don't know, I'll make that a fanfic if you want, I don't care. Alright, so let's grab this gem. Oh yes, I should probably do this. I've been holding off the announcement news because I don't want to sound like a fanboyish little girl. If that makes any sense, fanboyishly. Yeah, it does, it does. Because it makes sense because you're a fanboy, but you act like a little schoolgirl towards, you know, how your personality goes to being, you know, a fanboy to a real fan of someone. It's not good. It's the point of obsession, and it's not good. It's simply not good. It's not healthy. So pretty soon I'm gonna be in this live stream with another YouTuber, and it's like, is it Table Flipper 20? No, it's not Table Flipper 20. Is it one of his friends? Nope. It's somebody you would least expect to I would ever do some collab with. Well, not really a collab. There's gonna be other YouTubers there, I believe, but yeah, and I think he talked about this during his last live stream too. So, yeah. His name is Bullet Berry, and I've actually been talking to him for quite some time. A lot of people have. He's a real cool guy. He seems like a real cool guy. And yeah. So, oh shit. Oh fucking hell. Oh fuck you. Oh, what the fuck? Now I gotta go all the way back there. So, I'm going to be in a live in a community podcast live stream. I don't know. He said either it's gonna be a live stream or he's just gonna record it and throw it up on YouTube. And yeah, he even said, you know, I should ask them if they don't mind whether it be a live stream or, you know, just something. Or a podcast thrown up on YouTube. And I told him, actually, I should probably direct message him because I think he missed it during the Twitch, or during the stream. But anyway, so yeah, sometime soon, I'm going to be in a community podcast with Bullet Berry and a couple other YouTubers. Yeah, so I might record it. I probably will. It seems like something important to archive. So yeah, I'll record it. I'll record it. I'll and I'll be an asshole and I'll just cut to the parts where I'm talking. No. I'll you know, include the whole thing, of course. I there is no specific date yet. I just hope it happens on a night where I don't work the next day. So within these couple days would be perfect, but you know. And it's getting pretty close to the switch. I told Barry that we should do it before 8 March, because there's a lot of shit happening, a lot of great games being released in March. The Switch is being released in March. Oh shit, I missed it. I missed the message. I got them all right. Yeah, I did. I missed the message. Sorry. What was I saying? Oh yes, I told them we should do it before March because, you know, a lot of stuff's happening in March. The Switch is releasing. Kingdom Hearts 1 and 2 is being remastered for the 50 billionth time. Yooka-Laylee comes out next month. It's a bunch of big, huge, huge stuff happening in March. So, yeah, and it looks like it's going to be happening soon. So he's following that quota, which is good because I don't want to have to, you know, exclude myself out. Let's go in this one. I don't want to have to exclude myself out just because, oh, I want to make these videos on the Switch, or ooh, I don't want to miss out because I'm going to be playing all these games. But yeah. Alright, now let's actually talk about the game. This is a game, Steffi. Oh my god. Your face is so cute. I wanna eat out your fish pussy. I mean, what? Also, the music in here is so damn good. All right, so what she wants us to do is kill these Rhinox that charge. Also, these fucking mummy. Kind of Rhinox are back, but you know, this time they're not Rhinox, they're I don't even know what the fuck they're made out of this time. Also, freeze these. So yeah, check the map. Alright. Jump. Alright. Alright. I'm thinking, should I do a Let's Play of the first Spyro Season of Ice for GBA, you know, like a blind playthrough? Maybe? I don't know. I mean, I'll probably like beat it on my GBA first, but yeah, not a blind playthrough. I'm done doing blind playthroughs. They don't end good. Cause there's not Jackoff to commentate. You know, jack off to commentate. You see, with playing a game, you know, with playing a game that you've played before, you could take what you take. You can use stories that can be a good source of commentary, just so you don't run out of things to say. With a blind playthrough, you don't have that advantage. You don't have like, oh, I remember this part from my childhood. You know, it was really hard. No, because you never played the game before. Yeah, not. Oh, that was fucking bullshit. That was a load of bullshit because. Yeah, he got me fucking twice. That was shit. Alright, well, we gotta find some, whatever the gay thing's called. Wait. I can make this jump. I hope I can. Jesus Christ. Well, when I don't press the jump button, of course I'm not gonna make it, but at least we now have Sparks back, so that's a plus. Alright, so all the Rhinox are dead, so now we can just, you know, try to make the jump again. Fuck! please end my life now. Alright. Up here. Oh god, hit him, there we go. Okay, good. Wait, is that the, no, that's till later, okay. Okay, so, you're supposed to go over here. Okay, good, I just want to make sure I landed on it. Because you'll see yourself in the middle, you might see yourself, like, hovering over land and be like, yes, I made it, and then you'll drop, and then you'll just, you know, you'll realize your shadow's been over the water, so. Oh yeah, this is the fucking thief again. Yeah. We gotta go get the memes, the meme thing from the guy. I don't fucking know. All right. Wait. Did I? Oh shit. Okay, there's stuff up there. I'm a fucking idiot. Well, we saw it, and I forgot. Oh my god. Get out of here. Alright, so same thing, but just chase the guy all over. There's nothing else in here besides this guy. Alright, come on. You just gotta try to cut him off, like that. Alright, let's go. Alright. Wait, I know. I take this Royal Orb. This, thank you. Ouchie! What kind of orbs is this? What kind of? Why? Also, her sprite turns. I actually didn't see that. Why? Oh my god! It goes behind the porter. It's like fuck you. Wait, I heard a gem fall. Did I not Okay, yeah, I got it. I just heard it fall as I was walking away. Weird. Oh god. Oh god. Okay, good. Well, I could have got back up there and grab it, but whatever. Speedrun. Let's go, baby. Oh shit. No, I don't want to lose sparks. One. Let's go in here. What's in here? Oh yeah, the chest. Is there a chest in the stage? There should be. There's a chest in every stage. All right. Oh, shit, shit. Wait a minute. Yeah, there's no chest. I guess there's no chest in some stages. Alright. Alright, good. We got sparks back. Now we just gotta head back to that fucking place. Okay, so we're there. And we gotta head all the way back to the beginning. So, good job. I'll see you there. Fuck. All right. Actually, there's no point in editing that out. I just realized there's no point in getting rid of that. It's like a few seconds, a minute at the most. All right, we did it. So I think you know what comes next. Thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. Have a good day. Now let's watch as the gems count up in our magical chest. Ooh yeah. Brother, look at that. Look at that shit. Ooh yeah. Fill my chest with your love, brother.